This is the Thank You Ocean Report. Sharks are one of the most misunderstood species, sensationalized through movies, television, books, and popular myths. But one group of observers understand sharks from a whole different viewpoint. Scuba divers around the world are sharing their underwater perspective in an effort to protect the ocean.
For most people, scuba is a transforming experience. They have unique skills and ability to actually see what's happening underwater. Scuba divers can share that experience with people on land, and that's the unique value that scuba divers bring here.
Anya Bujak is the Associate Director for Programs at the Project Aware Foundation, and one area the group focuses on is shark and ray conservation.
Project Aware helps scuba divers connect as a community through our website, and that's where divers can share their stories and their experience and what they value. But what we also help do is we engage divers in various advocacy opportunities to influence shark and ray conservation policies.
And while the conservation issues related to sharks and rays are complex, their main threat points to overexploitation.
We're overfishing sharks and rays, so we're taking too many of them. Then we're taking too many of them through bycatch, so incidental catch, where sharks and rays are not really a targeted species, but they are being caught while we're fishing for other species, whether it's tuna or swordfish, etc. And then last, there is an issue of finning, which many might be somewhat familiar with, but that's basically the act of slicing off a shark's fin and then throwing the body back into the sea.
And she says that most shark and ray fisheries in the world are not regulated or under-regulated.
So what's needed here is concerted management where scientific advice is followed. There are limits on how many sharks and rays can be caught. And there is species-specific data reporting. And that is not yet happening in most of the shark and world fisheries. How sharks and rays are managed in the U.S. and in Australia and in the EU, to a large extent, is an example to follow, because shark and ray overexploitation is often associated with mismanaged fisheries of other species.
Yet most shark and ray fisheries are managed as if these animals produce quickly and grow fast, which is not the case for most shark and ray species.
The ocean is a very fragile ecosystem, and sharks and rays, each and every one of those 1,041 species, plus all the undiscovered ones, has a place in there. And we should be concerned about biodiversity loss in general and about biodiversity loss among sharks and rays in particular, then we definitely should care about that group of animals because they're some of the most threatened animals in the world.
Anya closes with two key messages for each of us.
Make wise seafood choices, but really knowing where our fish comes from. And then, of course, being active in advocacy, that is actually speaking out for sharks, but I don't only mean at the political level. I also mean in speaking out for sharks and rays, so the flat sharks as well, to your friends and to your family, and understanding the complexity of the whole group of these animals that requires protection, and caring and speaking out for the ocean and understanding our impacts on the ocean helps as well.
My thanks to Anya Bujak of the Project Aware Foundation. And here's your Thank You Ocean Everyday Action. Speak out against the overfishing of sharks and rays. And if you choose to eat seafood, be certain that it's coming from a sustainable source. I'm Jerry Kaye.